Charlie, you just picked up your first belt. There it is, by your waist. How did you find it, mate?
It was good, yeah. You know, I'm just happy, you know, the weight's off my shoulders now and it's done. You know, I spent 9-10 weeks training for that and I'll put everything into it, so I'm happy, you know. Like I said, the weight's off my shoulders now and I'm buzzing with the end result.
I didn't get to see too much of it, but I came out, I think it was in the fourth or the fifth round, and I was smiling because, you know, I've always said to you, I wanted to see you, you know, like, go for it.
Yeah, yeah.
You went for it, mate.
Yeah, well, that's, you know, you were coming forward as well, which was good. You know, I after like the fourth or fifth, I felt like I started to find my range a little bit more, and I was finding shots that I like to throw coming up with the uppercuts and whatnot, and the left hook over the top. And, you know, as tired as I was in there towards the end, you know, I did enjoy it as well, but I'm glad it's done.
Well, how did you find that? Because that's obviously your first eight rounder.
That's my first eight rounder, yeah. And, you know, no disrespect to previous opponents, but, you know, my last two or three fights, you know, I weren't pushed like that. So it was nice as well, looking back now already, mm-hmm. to, you know, get that a little bit more out of me, you know, to show a different side of what I'm about and what I can do.
Yeah, because you had a guy coming forward and coming at you.
Definitely, yeah.
And wanting to win
fight,
as well.
When someone wants to come and fight, I can find shots like that.
Steve, how did you find it, mate?
Well, you've got to give credit to the Chris Nixon as well, because, like you said, he has come to try and win. At the end of the fifth, he was completely gone. He hit him with three left hooks and he couldn't even walk to his stool. So, for him to come out and get through to the end, you've got to give credit to Chris. Yeah. But, you know, Charlie's had a proper fight tonight. Probably it's his first proper fight.
Yeah.
You can say that, and he come out, you know, with a belt, and he shows to me now he's ready to carry on and step
well,
up another level again.
We said this before, didn't we, at the weigh-in. You know, this was your first real test. This kid had fought good kids before, even though he'd been beat off them. Now you've just joined that bracket.
Yeah,
you know,
yeah.
I know I think you ranked number 10 with Boxer. Number 12.
I think it was 12 before coming into this.
Yeah.
You know, I think I'm the youngest in the top 20 as well. So hopefully, you know, with this win, that takes me into the top 10. And there's no rush. I'm under 24, and you know, I'm still learning. I've got loads to learn. But you know, if I can keep, you know, doing, you know, fighting people like that and onwards, and keep learning, you know, I'm sure I'm on the right path.
Well, Robert, how did you find that, mate? Because I think, did he deliver what you wanted him to deliver?
So, like, you know, it's hard with someone like that who comes forward. Like, you know, I was asking him to do certain things, which, you know, he kind of got involved in his fight. He was allowing him to smother his work and, you know, tying up, and he kind of got a little bit scrappy where, you know, he could have kept it simple, kept him on the end of his jab. And, like, he was doubling up. Chris was coming forward, doubling up, and it was so easy. I was saying, look, just bump right hand over the top and then step off and then follow your work up. Mm-hmm. But he seemed to just think it was just one and two and then tie him up and then that's enough. But I said to him, look, we need to get away from that. Pick your shots and don't allow him to keep coming and smothering your work. Which, for me, it wasn't a best performance by no means. And, look, I'm buzzing for him. He's happy and he's won and it's his first eight rounder. But he goes away from his fight.
Well, no, it probably was his best performance. But you know that you could do better because you've seen it in the in sparring and in gym work.
I watch him against kids who, you know, levels above
Jack Massey.
You know, even above, like, you know, who have got European level and stuff like that, he spars with. You see so much more of what he's, you know, what he's got in the tank, and I know where he can be. I just think sometimes I think he switches off, but I'm not always one to, you know, just to what's name, and I'm kind of, I criticise, I look at the wrongs more than the rights, but, you know, he's won the fight, and I'm happy.
What was it? So
there's more good than bad in there.
More good than bad.
And that's what you've got to take away, and now he's got that eight rounder under his belt. He's done the championship way, because he was bang on it yesterday. The confidence he'll get from this will make him a better fighter.
Oh, and also, you know, I mean, you're huge at the light heavyweight. I mean, what, you're 6'5"? And you've probably actually got room, because what did you weigh in this morning when you came in? Because you had the day before weighing on,
yeah,
this, didn't you?
Yeah, the day before weighing yesterday, 12.7.
Yeah.
I've not even checked the scales, to be honest, this morning. I know that in 24 hours, my body's been doing this diet, you know, for 9-10 weeks, so it wouldn't really put that much on, to be honest.
Oh, so that's what I'm saying. That's another way you can improve as well.
Yeah.
Because realistically, you should be stepping through those all 13 stone plus, shouldn't you?
Probably did.
Well, you know what I mean? But I mean, you know, the guys who are at the higher levels are probably stepping in there more like 13 and a half stone, even close to 14 stone, some of these guys, aren't they?
Yeah.
So, you know.
He's shown he can mix it, you know, and he's shown great as well. Like, he got caught with one big shot then. I think it was a left hook. He was on the ropes and he composed himself, and it was a big shot. He come back from it and straight away he took control again. But, yeah, no, I'm happy with it.
No, well, like I say, I was in here doing interviews, so I didn't get to see too much of it. But the round I did see, was that the fifth round? It must have been, because it was what I wanted to see. You know, you were putting it on the guy, giving him no rest. Mm. And, you know, you got out of there tired, which is, I must admit, you've not on, on some of the other occasions. Yeah. And that's right, you know, this is a title, and you want to be getting out of there and leaving everything in the ring, don't you?
Yeah, of course.
Especially when you train as hard as you train. Yeah, yeah. I know you train hard.
It gives you a good indication to where you're at. You know what I mean? So now he knows, like, where he's at. We know, you know, that next step. You know, it's going to get tougher and
the
tougher.
Man's here next year. What is that next step, Steve?
Listen, it's probably just blood, isn't it? So,
steady on, mate. I'm going out first.
Yeah. The next step, G Casino.
But is that next step before Christmas, or is it going to be after Christmas?
It'll be after Christmas now, and he's had an hard camp. And,
you're at a level now where you can't just be fighting anyone now. You've just put yourself in a new league.
Listen, Liam Conroy for the English title would be a perfect
fight. That'd be a great fight, yeah.
Maybe it's something we can do.
Yeah, perfect. All right, well, congratulations, mate.
Cheers, Lee.
Take care.
Nice one, mate.
Well done, Steve. Cracking night again. Bye-bye.